little darling. It's been a long, cold, 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 lonely winter. Remix. I picked up some Kalamazoo. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. If any of you gents have got a beard, or females, it's 2020, I know you like to do weird stuff like that. Any females or men that have got beards, this stuff is fantastic. Smells like really nice. It noticeable difference to the beard. It's getting a bit bigger, oh, it's bright. Okay, full day of eating. That sun's annoying, but I like it. It's giving a weird Tommy Shelby effect. Arthur, meet me at the garrison. We'll go for supplementation. If you are training fasted, Dr. Dean's electrolytes is a must. Having been fasted during our sleep and not getting in adequate hydration, then I would definitely recommend a couple of scoops of the electrolytes. Astrag Flow. I like taking this before training. Why are you taking kidney blood pressure? Well, the nitric oxide boosting ingredients within it, as mentioned in the previous episode, will add to a little pump. So, we'll go into more supplementation now. So we can consider this meal number one, carbohydrates and aminos. So 45 grams of the Carbomax with 27 grams of the Intra EA Plus. And then I'm yet to wean myself off this combination because I enjoy it so much. Naughty Boy Pineapple, Nova Pump Neuro in Green Apple. This has been one of those investments. It wasn't even an investment because they very kindly sent one out that I've been putting to good use. Massaging the body part that we're training before training. More so on leg day, I find that my hip flexibility is fantastic. So we'll do a bit of biceps, little bit of triceps, little bit of rear delt, and little bit of calf, because they're the muscles that we're training today. Oh, it's bloody frosted over, flokes. Floak and fluck, can't speak today.
Oi, 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 oi. It's Marley's 75th anniversary. And treat you right. I wanna love you. 75. He would have been 75.
Arm day. The pinnacle of a bro split, this isn't it, arms. It was needed though, because my upper B sessions were becoming so packed with volume. And the beauty of training upper lower, which leaves three rest days in the week, you can have one of those days for like a lagging body part. So strip back upper B, we've now got arms, rear delts and calves, which makes the upper B far more enjoyable because we don't have so much volume. And I think the novelty of training arms wears off a little bit, but one, I'm seeing progress, and two, I have a better understanding biomechanically of how to train arms. So it's week in, week out, I'm actually quite excited to jump in the gym and train them. But open up the workout with three sets, 8 to 10 on the EZ bar. See the straight bar, see the straight bars in the corner? I tried one of them the other day and horrendous. Shoulders, elbows. We shouldn't really be using a straight bar anyway, but just being so used to training D handles and EZ meant that straight bar was horrible. Now onto the tricep dips. Again, same sort of setup, three sets, 8 to 10, quite short rest periods on these, 60 seconds. But I'm so used to training the Cybex seated dip in the corner. If you train at Muscle Works, the seat is angled like that. So reversed it, relying on the seat belt here to keep us glued in. And just find a far better contraction in terms of shortening and lengthening the tricep here. When I did flip round and have the chest supported, I didn't like it at all. I felt almost it was slightly too wide. So went for the neutral grip in the inside and felt really nice. Onto some rope hammer curls. Again, you can sort of alternate these between seated dumbbell, but if you are doing them, I'd recommend probably having the chair on an incline, and we'll get to that. But those that are requiring or want that peak effect of a bicep, what's often overlooked is the hammer. And the brachialis is buried quite deep in underneath the bicep. So superficially, we can't really see it, but by doing these sort of movements, it does push it. And if you watch Jeff Nippard's videos, a really good in-depth understanding of how to train arms. But for a long time, when I started growing up, I used to type in how to get thick arms, because from the front, my physique, my arms look really skinny. So I used to do a lot of hammer work. I don't have the biggest arms, but in terms of the peak, and you've seen and people have mentioned in previous It's always horrible when you're gassing yourself up. Like, my arms are terrible, but they're not bad in terms of the peak. Things are pretty peak when you have small arms, but if you require it, then possibly look at implementing and programming some hammer movements. Onto the double rope. Again, just simplicity of using two ropes here so we don't get that internal rotation of the shoulders. I will alternate between this particular movement and the D handle. And you've seen in previous videos how to set that up, which is just the EZ bar shoulder width apart, and then you have the D handles there. Then onto this, which a lot of people, when you're in the, I'm getting into quite a habit of being photobombed during session. Remember the girl in the prep series? I watched this back on the edit. I thought, are you doing this on purpose? Anyway, don't get distracted. Listen to me. Look at me. A lot of us think that getting into that fully lengthened position with the bicep is just straight down. But if we were to put it past our body, and this particular movement is fantastic, and that's why incline curls feel phenomenal as well. Puts us into a very advantageous position. So next time, as a little finisher, I do the single arm, so isolation each arm, and then I'll also go into this, which is, you've seen it before, it's like a slightly odd movement, but I'll do it slightly slow for you guys and girls. When you're getting to that position, you're sort of elevating the shoulder, and Nunes talked about this, and he's a phenomenal tricep finisher. So next time you're in the gym, try it. Again, I will alternate between this and like a single arm cross body, either with the D handle or just holding it and placing my other arm underneath my elbow for support. But I find that the connection with this tricep finisher is fantastic. So high reps on this, 15 to 20. Same goes for the single arm bicep curls. Arms, calves and rear delts done. I like that session because it makes tomorrow's upper session more enjoyable because the volume decreases a little bit. So for post-workout meal, we are having carbohydrate sources, wires, two packs of apple and blueberry. I have some dark chocolate in there as well. There's some berries, six of the Warburton's pancakes. They're little ones, not the big ones. Big ones have got a bit too much fat in. And then two Rice Krispies squares bars. Well, let's do the old school way of YouTube 4 days of eating on MyFitnessPal. Two Rice Krispies square bars, six pancakes, two packs of oats, 15 grams of dark chocolate, our egg whites and some orange juice. So meal number one, 40 grams of protein, 188 carb and 32 grams of fat. Meal number two going in. Pit is a great way to get additional carbohydrates in. I think on off season, what's key is to get those different textures in your mouth, and it makes like a simple chicken and rice meal go down quite easily. So it is chicken and rice, but it's with the sweet chili lime tilde, and I shall pop some tomatoes in there. So different flavors going on, and then to top up my fats a little bit, reduce fat hummus. So macros for this meal are 56 protein, 130 carb and 14 fat. Time has come up to 5 o'clock. Consume this, do some work. And then our third meal will probably be sausages. Chicken sausages tonight. Tracksuit from Preview, by the way. And there's a light. Right, let's do this.
Oh, I've been working hard on this.
Room matching green.
Khaki lovers.
It's paying off, innit?
Massive batty.
Pork series is coming soon. Let's book Ibiza. Meal three going in. This is a meal that I tend to vary up a little bit. Sainsbury's have a fantastic turkey selection. So that's meatballs or sausages or the burgers that I had the other day. Because I go shopping every 3 days, I tend to choose whatever I fancy. It may also be the case that I want some Heck sausages. The chicken Heck sausages are really nice. So my meal three tends to be quite consistent with the carbohydrate choice, spaghetti or pasta, and then I'll just rotate my meat choices. While the spaghetti's cooking, we can go over the macros for meal number three. 54 grams of protein, 119 grams of carbs, and 20 grams of fat. This is a meal that we can, again, add in a pita or two when we come to increase carbohydrate intake over the next few weeks. The final meal number four has been prepared while Love Island is on. About to see Shauna's heart get broken into 1,000 pieces by that bastard Callum. Invested too much time into this series. It's a good one. Nice and easy to digest. Protein source, whey protein. Carbohydrates coming from the off-season goat of carbohydrate sources. Rice pudding with a little bit of jam. And one bagel. I kind of rotate these bagels. I get a bit sick of the cinnamon one, so I'll go for like a sesame. And I'll go back to the cinnamon. That's today's food topped off.
So that is all of today's food done. 199 grams of protein, 561 carb, and 78 grams of fat. Going further into that, 150 grams of sugar, 26 grams of fibre, and the rest we've got there. But that is a full day of eating done.
I'm going to leave the video there, folks, and pick up my new car. Upgraded a little hairdryer. Thinking long term though, got a 3008. Seems to have an allegiance with Peugeot. I'm aware these are quite short, these 4 days of eating. I might just string this out a little bit. So it's a little bit longer than it usually is. Got my beard trimmed. Going to Paris tomorrow. On the Eurostar. Hope I don't catch coronavirus, or COVID-19 as they call it now. But I should be okay. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you, good man. Much love.